today I thought I would try something different. I subscribe to a few magazines, and I figured maybe once a month I will pick out an article or a picture or a certain topic from a magazine that we can talk about, so we can have a different topic on the table each month and hopefully open up some discussions and have some interesting conversations and inputs from everybody. This will be more of a fun segment that may touch on some other issues, but for the most part, I'm going to keep it light and fun. But, you know, put in some requests for topics and ideas, and I will try my best to open it up, and let's have some fun and discuss a few things. Now, I'm a big lover of fashion. I love fashion. So I subscribe to a few fashion magazines. So this month we will talk about InStyle. And this is their November issue. And the one I want to talk about is their Inside InStyle, inspired by InStyle. Now, this is where they take pictures of a normal, everyday woman dressed in a style that's been inspired, that's been shown in the InStyle magazine. So, hold on a minute, and I will show you the page that we will be talking about today. All right, so this is the page that we will be focusing on today, and this is Inside InStyle magazine, the November issue, and it's their Inside InStyle, inspired by InStyle page. And basically, what this page is about is it features an everyday woman wearing a color or style or a certain trend that's been previously featured in the magazine. So, for example, in this picture here, this woman here is wearing a yellow skirt, and the yellow color has been previously featured in a magazine. And over here, this lady is wearing a full circle skirt, which is a trend that was featured in the magazine the month earlier, and she's interpreted the trend and made it into her own style, and I think she looks really great. And down here, now it is this picture that I want to focus on specifically today. Now, this beautiful lady here is wearing the crop top trend. She's wearing a crop top over a long maxi silk skirt. And I want you to keep this picture in mind as I zoom out of here. And we will have a small discussion about this specific image. So do keep it in mind. And I'm going to go ahead and zoom out now. So what did you think about the picture? I thought that she looks beautiful. Obviously, she's a very beautiful woman, and she is glamorously dressed. But on the other hand, I thought that she was overdone, and it's not a good representation of an everyday woman. Now, I found that it was a little bit uptight and not modern. It's not the modern kind of fresh take on fashion that I love. I love the everyday woman dressing. Now, to me, an everyday modern woman is a woman who is savvy, and she doesn't just fall for every designer label, and she doesn't just fall for the higher price tag just for the sake of it being a designer brand. Now, What appeals to me more, and what is the ideal normal woman who knows how to navigate in this materialistic world is somebody who appreciates the finer things in life, but she's savvy and she knows how to shop for the deals. And she doesn't always go after every trend out there, and she has a natural quality about her, and she knows who she is, and she has a natural, easy chicness to her, and that's the ideal everyday woman to me. And today we live in a world where we're constantly bombarded by magazines and TVs, and the internet is constantly showing us images of things that tempt us. And whether if your hobby is fragrance or handbags or makeup or fashion, cars, that can be a dangerous hobby. But it can all become so overwhelming, and we really have to be savvy and navigate ourselves through today's world to not lose ourselves in the materialism. Now, I am definitely not one to preach about this. I love fashion. I love my handbags and makeup and perfumes, but I tend to think of them more as the sprinkles on my sundae. They're definitely not necessary, but they are fun, and we have to be picky and choosy about what we go for. And I don't think that there's any shame in shopping for deals and sales and clearance, and there is definitely no shame in mixing high quality pieces with low quality, not low, but more affordable pieces, and just the mix of it actually creates a more interesting look, and you will look relatable and interesting, and not so uptight. And we've moved on from the head to toe designer looks now. I surely hope we're beyond that. And I think that we should open up the topic, and as people and consumers and women talk about the great deals there is to be had, and also promote comfortable, easy fashion for the everyday woman, so that we don't push ourselves into a corner of always having to obtain the latest and greatest things in fashion, but yet we can enjoy fashion casually and be choosy and savvy in this world. So maybe we can help each other with the dialogue. Now, I will be the first to say that I am a bargain hunter. I shop from eBay. I buy things new, and I buy some designer pieces here and there at a very discounted price, and I hunt them down, or I shop for deals online. And that's how I acquire some of the nicer pieces that I have. I believe in being comfortable too. I'm not going to sacrifice myself and my comfort to be fashionable. I'm sorry, I love fashion, but when I put on something and I'm not comfortable in it, I just don't feel like myself. So comfort, I believe, is another important factor in fashion. Now, I would love to hear your comments. Let me know how you dress, how you like to dress, and what your ideal everyday woman is like, and how she navigates through the world today, as far as her shopping habits and how she likes to present herself. Now, that's it for today, and I will see you next time. And once again, please leave your comments. I would love to hear your thoughts.